My name is Mario Bergés. I'm an assistant professor in the Civil and Environmental Engineering Department. I'm also the co-director of the Smarter Infrastructure Analytics Lab, and I work on discovering ways to understand energy consumption in buildings by using sensing and machine learning. My group is working on looking at ways in which you can disaggregate the total consumption of a building, total electricity consumption, into individual appliances and give you at the end of the day something that says, okay, so in refrigeration you spent this much, in cooling and heating your house you spent this much, lighting this much, and that is a better standing point for you to make decisions. To give you a sense of how we're actually understanding the individual consumption patterns of appliances in your house, I'm going to show an example here of a coffee machine that we instrumented here in the Civil and Environmental Engineering Department. So this coffee machine is one of those where you put in quarters and it gives you coffee, tea, or mocha, depending on what you select. And what you can see from this graph is that we're able to detect when the heater is keeping the water hot. So this is what happens in these patterns. This is just the heating element keeping the water hot. But we're also able to detect when, for example, tea is being dispensed, which would be corresponding to these little blimps right here, and also when coffee or mocha is being dispensed. My group is interested in looking at ways to better inform the occupants of the building and also the facility managers about the energy consumption of the building. Also looking for ways to make buildings more intelligent so that they can control themselves and they can manage themselves in terms of energy consumption. And then lastly, we're also looking at ways in which we can integrate the buildings into this concept that is now very, very much a research topic, which is the smart grid. So this idea of making buildings be part of the solution to controlling the demand and supply of energy in our power network. So one of the things we're interested in finding out is whether or not we can identify individual appliances by just looking at the measurements of their voltage and current consumption. So we have this plug meter that allows us to test that hypothesis. So I'll connect this plug meter to a series of appliances that I have for test. And this plug meter will wirelessly report voltage and current measurements to the computer, as you can see over here. And right now, the only thing plugged in is a computer charger, a laptop charger. And on the top, we can see the average power consumption. On the bottom left, we can see the voltage. We can see then the current and this VI trajectory, which is basically just voltage and current plotted in one single graph. And what you can see from there is that this particular shape is correspondent to what is happening right now, which is just the computer charger. But as soon as I turn on another appliance, let's say, for example, I want to turn on an incandescent light, this shape will actually change because the current has changed. And we're using that representation to understand what type of appliance actually turned on. So for example, if I turn on now a fluorescent light, a compact fluorescent light, this shape will change even further. And as you can see, it is pretty distinctive of the thing that is actually happening right now. So for example, a compact fluorescent light. I'll turn on another incandescent light just so that you can see the change. And what we're doing is training the computer to automatically understand these shapes in the same way that computers have been trained to do, for example, facial recognition, face recognition, or handwritten recognition. We're using the same algorithms, and we're teaching the computer how to represent these signals. So if you want to see what the computer is actually looking at, I can show you a series of images of the things that it's highlighting the most from the individual voltage and current trajectory that you saw before. So as you can see, these images show that it's highlighting specific shapes that correspond to individual appliances of different types. Some of these correspond to microwaves, some of these correspond to refrigerators, some of these correspond to lamps, and it's already automatically training itself on what features are the right ones to focus on in order to solve this appliance identification problem. It has applications on all kinds of buildings, but the economics of deploying these solutions are different for every type of building. So my guess is that we will see this taking place primarily on commercial and industrial buildings first, which have the most bang for the buck when you're thinking about the cost and the benefits of these applications. And then those solutions will trickle down to smaller buildings until they get to the homes, and you'll be able to see them in your house as well.